I could wake up next to you every single morning. Place the coffee on the bedside table, kiss your forehead. Listen to Jack on the stereo walls, wake up slow. Some breakfast and bed rest over the TV remote. Every morning, just when you smile and I'm smiling.
Tell us, how you doing? And we've only, what, done 8Ks?
Yeah, we're not so far in.
And we've got like another 12 to go today.
Yeah, something like that.
And look at that hill we're going up. Yeah, see the path?
It's only this big.
Yeah, on the map it was smaller.
It's epic.
Yeah, it's epic.
Yeah. It's not easy. But I'm doing it. Check how far we've come.
Tell me about your day, darling. How you feeling? Count your freckles like a star.
Say hello.
Oh, hello.
Oh. I'm feeling older than 40 at this point.
Whew. Every evening, just when you smile and I'm smiling, and when you're thinking, I'm thinking.
We finished having lunch at the base of this. And not that part up there, okay? We're climbing up to there and over there. So the boys have kindly said that they will carry our packs up this part while we traverse it. From down there,
yeah. That is why we look like this.
If I don't have carbs at the end of this one, yes.
Yeah, when you smile, I'm smiling. And when you're thinking, I'm thinking about what you're thinking about. Every morning.
What's up, people?
We're snuggling.
Yeah.
Spoon.
In the world's smallest tent. It's official. It's smaller than Haley and Graham's little tent.
This is true. I think it's smaller than Haley's bed by itself.
But it is keeping us alive because outside, I reckon it's dropped down to zero. I see ice on the floor and stuff.
If not below. Down to the sky, we dance with monsters through the night. Whoa, oh, oh. Below.
We climbed that insane gully last earlier today.
Yeah,
took us from the bottom to the top. It was 2 hours, right?
Yeah, just for I'd say less than a kilometer.
Yeah,
two hours.
So it was half a kilometer an hour. It was insane.
So I have officially bailed on doing the summit though.
I'm still in two minds because I mean I came here to climb. They say that the summit is 2.5 hours what, there and back.
No, 2.5 hours there.
2.5 hours. All right, it's morning. It's 3:30.
Wednesday morning. It is bitterly cold.
The wind was howling. I can't believe I didn't sleep last night. Struggled. At one point I had to get up and pee, and it was just horrible. So we are going to be summiting today. I've decided that I'm going to be doing it. And thankfully we can leave our backpacks at the tents, and Richard's going to look after them. So all we have to do is take water and snacks, which I'm quite excited about, so I don't have to lug that massive bag. 5 hours there to the summit and back, and then from here we're going to walk another
18-19
kilometers back to the chalets. So we made it. Hey guys, little pile of rocks.
That is the highest peak.
Took a long time to get to the side of the rocks.
It took us a very, very long time.
A long time.
What's the time now?
It's 16 minutes past 6.
So it took us 3 hours effectively.
From camp. Plus the hole yesterday.
I'm so amped to get back to chalet by end of today, but my body's just saying, no buddy, you're sleeping another night in the mountain.
It's not gonna happen.
And I don't wanna.
It's not gonna happen. Just remember, as you drop low,
you'll feel better.
100%.
Yeah. Look at that view.
No, I'm back.
Yeah. The whole world is covered in clouds. Up our camp, we're now heading down Judge's Pass, which is a much, much easier route, but it's longer. It's all walking, there's no climbing or anything to be done. And that is where we're going to be going.
You stand out, one foot in front of the other, open your mind, so much to discover. Oh, make sense of it. Oh, no, my bag.
We've just left Centennial Hut, done 25 kilometers today, another 10 to get back to the chalets, so that we can have a shower, climb in bed, and enjoy the last night here.
When you say, don't go, please don't go away.
So, last day, 20 past 5, we majority of the way back. We've only got about 2 hours left of walking through a forest, which is pretty cool. Good news is we're almost done. Bad news is we're going to come in at about 7 o'clock, which will be dark, so we're prepping for night walking. I've got such blisters on my feet, I'm so sore, so I've decided I'm going to be doing the rest of it in my Crocs. Well, Mike, you'd be so proud of me.
Make sense of it all. Why you scared? Don't let life slip by. The same 4 walls, the same 9 to 5. Oh no, makes sense of it.
It's 9:30. Finally got back. I'm done. My legs are shattered. My knee is shattered. My hips are shattered. My back is shattered. I can safely say I'm never doing this again. You're gonna go next time?
Maybe.
Okay. But I'm never doing it again. So it's the morning after, and we've already done about 100 kilometers. We stopped close to Harry Smith. We had a mug and bean breakfast, all that we could think of for breakfast today, and what got us down the mountain. It was superb. I'm so stiff, I can't even get up and down curbs right now. But we've got about another 3 hours to get home, and then we're done. But honestly, I think I'm sleeping on the couch tonight. I'm not going up those stairs. Thank you.